So now we gotta go get two of everything. We gotta get two bottles, two pacifiers, two cribs, two strollers, two car seats, about 2,000 diapers, two blankets.
Two bikes?
Yeah, two bikes.
Dad?
Yeah?
Why do people have twins?
I don't know. It just happens sometimes.
How come?
Well, it's got something to do with chromosomes.
Dad?
Yeah?
What's chromosomes?
Well, I would imagine that's something better for your science teacher, Mr. Cattleman, but that's what makes babies babies.
Oh.
Don't mow these people down. Say beep, beep.
Beep, beep. The twins always look exactly alike.
Well, sometimes they do and sometimes they don't.
Well, what if they're exactly alike, but they both turn out to be kind of funny looking?
Kids are always beautiful to the people that love them, even you.
Ha ha. When I grow up, are my kids going to be twins?
Maybe. It could happen.
I hope so. Then they can grow up together and be best friends forever and ever.
Yeah. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? Mommy asked. She's not fat, right? Okay. Oh, the race is on. I'll race you home.
Here you go, sir.
Here they come, neck and neck, going down the home stretch. Oh, the integration's got a slight lead, but here comes Mommy. Hey, there's Mom. Hey, honey, special delivery. Mint chocolate chip ice cream.
This is it.
It's time?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay, go get suitcase just like we practiced. That's right. Honey, I'm gonna get in the car. No, you get in the car.
I need to get my stuff, honey.
All right, you call the doctor. I'm gonna call the doctor. And you get your stuff. You got Mommy's suitcase. Good. Okay, we got everything. Let's go.
Honey, do you think I should call her?
Oh, it's up to you. Just hurry.
Hello, Mama. It's Tammy. Oh, honey, pull over, please.
Sure, Dad.
Pull over.
We're in a hurry.
Stop.
Lucille.
It's the last stop, I promise.
Don't you dawdle in there.
Tammy called. I'm on my way to the hospital. She's having the twins.
I knew she'd call. Sooner or later, they all realize they need their mama.
I keep thinking this is our second chance. These babies are going to bring our family back together again.
These will be for me. Oh, how precious.
I wish they could stay babies. I think they're just about perfect when they're 6 months old.
We can settle up later. You just get on over to that hospital now.
I'll call you.
Oh, give Tammy a big kiss.
I will.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Breathe. Oh, honey, you're doing so good. Halfway there, you're doing so good, honey.
Is Jesse okay?
Jesse's fine. Jesse's great. Oh, ready? Okay, and 1, 2.
All right, Tammy, you're doing great.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Call?
Fidel Benton.
Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Doctor, I think you should look at this.
Five,
just a minute.
6.
Sidell, get Dr. Sidell now.
What? What's wrong? What?
Mama, we're going to go home for a bit, see if maybe we can get some sleep. Maybe you and Daddy should go home, see if you can get some rest, too.
Oh, I can't leave Tammy now. I'll call you when it happens.
I'd better go, too. I have a 7 a.m. flight back.
Robin, you came all this way.
I have to go back to New York, Mama. I've got to work.
Funny thing about labor. You two popped out in no time, one right after the other.
I'll see you at Christmas, Daddy.
Okay, baby.
Night, night. Tammy's in trouble. I didn't want to scare the kids.
Now, don't go jumping.
She was only in labor 2 hours with Danny, and he was her first. I never had any trouble.
Hush, baby, do you hush?
Well, are we grandparents yet?
Jean, Tammy's pregnancy. She wasn't having complications, was she?
Well, she had a few bad days, I guess.
Why didn't she go to Dr. Stewart? He delivered all my babies. If Dr. Stewart was here, we would not be waiting.
Lucille.
Doctor. Ma'am. Is she okay? My daughter, Tammy, is she okay?
She's fine.
And the babies?
She had two boys.
Why didn't you say they were fine, too? Something's wrong, isn't it?
The father will be out in a while.
If there's something wrong with my daughter's babies, I want to know now. We have been sitting up all night. My husband is worried sick.
Ma'am, it is not my place. Bob will be out soon.
He'd get married to a Fekir's girl, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
I've known Mary since the third grade. And I saw you when you were a baby in the tub. So don't you act like some high and mighty doctor. Because when I tell your mama that you didn't have the decency to tell three worried
all right, Mrs. Jenkins, all right. Jordan came second. He had a very difficult delivery. He wasn't breathing. He lost a lot of blood. He's on oxygen right now.
Sweet God in heaven. And the other baby?
Jesse's delivery went well. But he has Down syndrome, ma'am.
You mean retarded?
Could be a mild retardation, ma'am. We won't know for a while. He's a bit weak now, but he should do okay. I'm sorry.
Didn't you know? Aren't there tests that
your daughter is only 25, ma'am. Downs is rare with a woman that age. Amnio wouldn't have been worth the risk for the fetuses. I am sorry.
Mama's here for you. It's gonna be okay. We'll be fine. You here?
There are a couple of special schools and one or two outpatient programs in the area. Now, you'll be eligible for assistance. I've got a list of agencies for you to contact when you feel ready. I'm just going to leave these here. I just want you to know there's help available if you need it. Information and advice, other parents who are raising Down syndrome kids, if you want to talk. Look, I know this can be overwhelming. Just get some rest, and I'll be back later.
Hey!
Hi!
I helped Nanny put cribs up.
Oh, did you, honey? That's great.
No.
hope you were good, Slugger.
Of course he was. He's my boy. Here you go. I've got him, Bob. Why don't you get Tammy's bags?
Mama, I can take one of those.
Honey, you know how heavy these contraptions are. Let me.
Come on, sweetie.
I'm gonna be late. Listen, honey, I'm getting off the night shift, that's why.
I know.
I love you.
I love you too.
I'll see you.
Bye, Lucille.
Bye. I don't know what we're gonna do.
Hey, honey. Daddy and I had our hands full when we brought Robin and Lucy home from the hospital. But we made out fine, didn't we?
But, Mama, you didn't have to work. You didn't have doctor bills. You didn't have a sick baby. And another one with Down syndrome. An 8-year-old to take care of all at once.
You make it sound like you're in this all by yourself. You're not. You have a mama and a daddy who love you.
Mama, I know we've had our differences.
But I'm telling you... That doesn't mean anything now.
Shh, shh, shh.
Lord doesn't give us more than we can handle. And he just sent us a pair of angels.
Mom! Daniel Frazier, I asked you to be quiet around the babies.
It's busted. It's totally busted. I hate this old computer game. You told me I could get a new one.
Danny, honey, we'll get you a new one tomorrow. Danny, that computer game is for Christmas, and that's if you're good, remember? Honey, I don't mind. And you don't throw your toys. I'm gonna make supper, and you do your homework, okay?
Would you look at him? He's the cutest.
I know I shouldn't say this, but of all the grandkids, Jesse's becoming my favorite. I just feel so close ever since the first time I held him.
Maxine's sister-in-law, one down in Huntsville, she had her one of them Down syndrome babies. And once they got over the shock and all, why, it turned out to be such a blessing.
Well, they have just the sweetest dispositions.
Don't you, Jesse?
Lady at the mental health department told me, you put Jesse in a normal environment, and you can raise him up to learn to his full capacity. Those were exact words. Full capacity. All the books said the same thing. 6238. Not bad for a Wednesday morning. Okay, Jesse. Nanny's here.
Yes. It's nice that you and Tammy finally made up.
Oh, just in time. Tammy hadn't had much experience with babies. I'm really the one who raised Danny. Danny was just a baby herself.
I'm sure she's grateful.
Well, I'm glad to help. Feels good to be needed again.
Hi, you two.
Hey, Jesse, look who's here.
What'd the doctor say? Oh. Well, he did the brain ultrasound, and it looks good. It looks like Jordan's gonna be okay.
Oh, that's a relief. All right, you two hang up your coats, and I'll have supper ready in no time.
We just came to pick up Jesse, Lucille.
You're not staying for supper? I know you must be exhausted. And I made enough for an army.
Thanks, but what with me working nights? First chance we got to be together, just the family.
But that's what I'm saying. Daddy's coming home. We're all going to be together.
Mama, Bob and I have some things we need to talk about, so we'll do another time.
Beautiful.
I didn't hear you come in.
Where are the kids?
They didn't want to stay. And after I made a whole supper and everything. I think Bob's holding a grudge, that's what I think.
Tell you what. Why don't you go upstairs and change? Let a handsome fella take you out for a steak dinner and some dancing. Unless you got a date with another man.
Baby. I've been on the go all day. What am I going to do with all that food?
Come here, give me this. Give me this stuff. Come on. We need to relax. Come
Lamar.
Come on. See? Isn't that better?
House seems so quiet lately. I guess I took it for granted all those years. Sounds like kids playing and laughing. I thought it would never end. Didn't you?
Well, we got grandkids now. I think that's even better.
You know, first I was really worried. But I think everything's gonna work out with Tim.
That's my girl.
Lamar, how many of those antacids did you eat today?
It's nothing. It's just a hard day, that's all.
That airline is not gonna go bankrupt if you come home early once or twice a week. I don't want that ulcer to start up again,
yes,
you hear?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
With the doctor, Mama. I didn't have time to get them dressed. I just had to grab the kids and go.
Okay. Don't we love having the kids?
I want to admit Jordan for observation, so I have to go and sign some papers.
Well, go on. You'll be fine.
Mama, the thing is, Jordan is so sick all the time. Now it's asthma, and I've been talking to a lot of people, you know, and Jesse, he needs extra attention and stimulation, and I hardly have any time for him.
Things will look better tomorrow.
But tomorrow will be exactly the same. I can't. It's just not fair to Jesse.
I understand, honey.
You do, Mama, because Bob and I, we realize there's a limit to how much we can cope with, you know?
Every new mother feels that way. Even I did.
But it'll get better, you see.
Now, let's get these kids to bed.
Mama, we really need to talk.
I know, honey. You call me as soon as you know some more from the doctor. Night-night. Say night-night.
Sweetheart? Oh, the coffee.
I feel so blessed, don't you? You have brought this family back together again. You know that?
You're about the luckiest little boy in the whole wide world. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Because you have so many people who love you.
Give me this finger for you.
Mama first.
Honey, that's all you've been trying to do. You know your mama only hears what she wants. She's been out of our lives for a year.
and it's been great. And now, bam, she's starting to take over again.
It's not gonna happen this time. I promise.
This has got to be our decision, honey, not hers.
If we do give Jesse up, is he gonna think we did it because he's different?
What are we gonna tell Joker when he's old enough? I want to do the right thing. I want to do what's gonna be best for Jesse. I just don't know if I'm strong enough. Strong enough to give him up.
I don't know why you dragged me out to bother these people.
I told you, Mama. They know everything there is to know about raising kids with special needs. They've got 11 of them.
11?
Yes, they're incredible. I really want you to get to know them, okay?
Hey, Daddy. Come here, buddy.
Hi. Hey, Tammy. Oh, good to see you.
Daddy boy, what's up?
Can I go play out back?
Oh, you bet.
I'm so glad you made it. We were hoping you would. You must be Tammy's mom. I'm Peggy Young. This is my husband, George.
How you doing?
Please, come on, let me show you around. Oh, the kids will be so excited. They've been pestering me about when they're going to see Danny.
Have they?
Yeah. Especially Natalie. I think she's got a crush on him.
It's not usually this quiet. The little ones are still napping. The dining room? There's a lot of chairs.
Well, we all like to eat together as a family. All the kids take turns setting the table. They learn to serve themselves. Follow me. Kitchen's right through here. Hey, kids.
Hi.
Hi. Now, Brian's what we call severe, but he dresses himself and does his chores just like all the other kids. And Tommy was originally classified severe when he first came to us, but pretty soon we realized he was really functioning closer to mild. So we fought to give him his other class. Now he reads, he does math. He's just amazing.
Kids, this is Tammy's mother, Mrs. J. E-N-K-I-N-S. Jenkins. Say hello.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Louise's got a job down at the mall. She works two afternoons a week.
You, must have folks come in and help with the cleaning and the washing and all that.
Oh, no, we do it ourselves, like any family.
But 11 children.
Well, actually, it's, 15. We got 4 kids of our own besides the kids we've adopted.
Hey!
15 children.
Yeah.
We work together. It's all learning for our kids.
Shall we?
Go on, Mama.
Come on, let's go upstairs. I'll show you the bedrooms. This is the kids' art gallery. Lisa. Tiffany, Patsy, Jan, and that's Debbie. See, we just took in little Lisa. Her mom abandoned her in the hospital, so we moved Debbie in with the big girls. But she's so attached to Jan, we keep finding her back in here. She even changed Jan's diaper yesterday. George and I couldn't believe it. Did you ever see a 5-year-old change a 2-year-old's diaper?
Can't say as I have. I'm not criticizing. I'm just saying I find the place depressing.
But, Mama, Peggy and George are so great. The kids are so happy.
I grew up on a farm with 10 brothers and sisters and no money. I know what it's like, and believe me, there's nothing romantic about 2 people trying to raise up 15 kids.
Mama, those are good things. They've dedicated their whole lives to this. They're educated. They know so much about Down syndrome.
Mom, Drew's beating us again. It's gross. I'm going to be sick.
Yeah.
Daddy, hush up. Mama, I just wanted you to see.
If you think they're so great, let me ask you this. What kind of mother leaves her baby in a place like that?
Well, maybe someone who doesn't know much about Down syndrome and doesn't think she can do a good job.
Poor kids. Mothers are probably drug addicts or Lord knows what else, lowest of the low. I guess those kids are better off than the Youngs. But you can't tell me that every one of them doesn't wish that he had a real family like ours instead of living in some institution.
It's not an institution. Daddy, put that back. It's full of sugar. Mama. Bob and I need you to understand something.
Tammy, you're right. I have nothing against those people. I'm just grateful you're not one of those poor people with no family to help out.
Oh, no, Mama, these are my groceries.
Oh, don't be silly. It's my pleasure. And anything you need for Jesse, you just have to ask. Anything. You know that, don't you? Well, now that you're in the family, I guess I'll have to reveal my secret ingredient. I'm gonna make a Jenkins out of this girl yet.
I don't know, Donna. I'd run for the hills if I were you.
Pay no attention to
him. I never do.
Well, Rick, I called your sister up in New York today. That man answered the telephone again. Robin's not living with him, is she?
Mama, how would I know? You know how Robin is. She never tells us anything.
And if she did, you wouldn't tell me, would you?
Probably not.
Hey, you guys! You want to come in and lick the bowl? Chocolate frosting! Fresh lemonade!
Okay, just a minute.
It's so good to have Tammy back again. When Tammy gets here, it'll be the first time in I don't know when, but most of the family's been together.
You hear from the hospital?
They put Jordan on a respirator. But Tammy, I think she's a bit overwhelmed.
So sad. I think she made the right decision.
What decision?
Tammy's been trying to tell you, Mama. I think she's a little scared.
Scared? Of what? I'm her mama. What on earth can't she tell me? What decision? Where's Tammy Frazier?
Right there.
How could you?
Mama?
Tell me you're not going to give Jesse to those people.
Mama?
Tell me you are not going to give my grandson to strangers.
Look, this isn't the time or the place, Mama. People are looking at
us. I don't care who's looking at us. I want to know about Jesse.
I'm sorry. I can't do this right now, Mama. I've got to go talk to the doctor.
Don't you walk away from me when I'm talking to you. I am your mother, and I'm telling you, you are not going to give that baby away.
Stop it, Mama.
She'll listen to us. You'll see.
Honey, I'm sorry. I didn't understand what you were going through.
I love Jesse, Mama, but I can't raise him, not the right way.
Tammy, baby, this is your son. Now, there must be something we can say to make you change your mind.
No, Daddy. I gotta get the kids.
Tim. Daddy and I will take Jesse. We talked it out.
Mama, I want the Youngs to raise Jesse.
No, Tammy. He's special, Mama. He needs a special home. How can you give your baby away?
I'm not just giving him away.
What do you call that, sweetheart? You're going to sign him over to some strangers?
Who let us see him as much as we want to.
Oh, sure. That's what they say now. But they're strangers. How do you come to let us see him? And right here, he has a nanny and a grandpa who love him and are willing to give him everything.
But I don't want you to give him everything. That's how you loved us, Mama. You bought us things. And money is just not going to fix this.
Jesse is retarded, Mama. And nothing you or Daddy can buy him is going to make that go away.
We always did our best for you. I guess it just wasn't good enough.
Look, what would happen if you did take Jesse and he grew up all alone here? What's going to happen, Daddy, in 30 or 40 years when you and Mama are gone?
Well, we're his family, sweetheart. He'd always have a place here.
This is not your decision to make.
It's Bob, isn't it? This is his idea. You would have never thought this way when you lived with us.
Well, maybe for the first time since I met Bob, I feel like I have a right to live my own life, Mama, to trust myself. I am grown. I gave birth to Jesse, and now I want to give him a life.
I don't know you. Not my daughter.
Mama, please.
I don't know who you are.
All right. I'll talk to Bob about what you said. I'll tell him about you raising Jesse, all right?
I just know that he'd do so much better here with individual care and attention instead of some institution. He'd be lost there.
We'll talk about it, okay?
Tammy. We're his family. His family.
Thanks, Daddy.
Tammy.
Sweetheart.
I know that you'll do what's right. You know, your mama got real shook up today at the hospital. She was just so upset.
You don't have to keep apologizing for her, Daddy.
I'm not. Baby. Now, your mother and I may have our faults, but everything that we have ever done has been out of love.
Then why doesn't it feel like love, Daddy? I'm making the hardest decision of my life, and I don't feel loved. Look, it's late. I gotta go.
Okay. Good night, baby.
Good night.
Made up her mind.
Hey, Jess. Oh, don't you look sweet in that nice soft blanket? You look so cozy, like a little bunny.
My mama made this blanket. She brought me and my brother and sister home from the hospital in it, and I brought Danny home in it.
You should take it then.
No, it's part of Jesse's heritage. I want him to have it.
It'll take a couple of weeks for the adoption to go through. You can change your mind at any time. No.
Jesse's home now.
That's why we want Jesse adopted with your name. Same name as the family he grows up in.
You've given us a real treasure. We won't let you down.
I know. Danny. Honey. I wanted you here today because I wanted you to see how much love there is here for Jesse. And for you and Jordan, too. And someday, if one of your brothers asks you about it, you can tell them about today so they'll understand, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Mar? Who was that on the phone?
It's Ricky. Says it's already done, sweetheart. Tammy has, signed Jesse over. You know, maybe we should have told Tammy first. Get that. You sure you can do this?
The way this started was Peggy and I used to work in a home for mentally handicapped adults. We began to realize it was already too late for them. Nobody had taught them when they were young how to work with others, how to care about people. And they weren't cute little babies anymore. They were selfish and spoiled and not acceptable in the normal world. It doesn't matter how smart you are, you're not socially acceptable.
You say the adoption hasn't gone through yet?
The courts still have to finalize it.
We don't see why we can't raise Jesse ourselves. Couldn't you just give him to us?
That wouldn't be our place. It's the parents' decision.
Well, our daughter has signed away her rights.
I wish somebody would explain this to me. Would you give your baby away?
Well, no, I wouldn't personally, but that I chose this life. And for some parents, it's...
But you don't know Tammy. Did she tell you she got pregnant when she was 16?
Well, no, but I just don't...
16 years old. And we stood by her through a bad marriage and took her back home again after a year when it blew up. And we raised Danny as if he was our own son.
And we do the same thing for Jesse, and she knows that.
She is just dragging you in to punish us. That's what she's doing, to punish us for something. You see, Danny loves us so much that he didn't want to leave us when Tammy married Bob. But whose fault is that?
Ma'am, see, all of that's between you and your daughter. See, all we want to do is help kids with Down syndrome, and Tammy came to us for help. We're going to have to work it out with her.
Danny?
Hi, Danny.
This is from Grandpa and me for you.
A Nintendo!
Oh, Mama. Danny, honey, you go wait in the car, okay? Give me this. I'll hold on to it. I'll be right there, okay? Go on.
Hey, Mike!
You can't hide from us, Tammy. You can't not answer your phone. You're killing your daddy.
He's my baby.
He's our grandson.
Like Danny? You know, you never even gave me a chance to raise him, Mama. You just took him over when we moved back in with you after the divorce.
My God, I was right. Not even about Jesse.
This is about Danny.
Do you have any idea what Bob and I go through just to get him to listen to us? To respect us as his parents? With you ready to run his life and play Santa Claus every day? You just did it again. You make us compete with you for his love, Mama.
That's ridiculous.
You know, after everything you pulled last year, and Bob adopted Danny, I thought maybe you were finally ashamed of yourself. You could change. But I knew that you just tried to take over again if I let you near those babies.
I am just trying to help. That is all I have ever tried to do. I love you. And I love Jesse. I didn't come to argue. I came to ask you one last time to let Jesse grow up with his family. Or let us raise him if you won't.
No.
That's your decision, Tammy. I might as well tell you that your daddy and I are ready to call a lawyer.
What?
If that's what it takes to save Jesse, that's what it takes.
Mama, you call a lawyer and it is over between us. I mean it. I have given in to you my whole life, but not over my baby. And you better think twice before you tear this family apart just to prove you're right.
You're the one, Tammy. You're the one breaking up the family. I just pray to God you come to your senses.
Can't stand it. Can you? That I could do something without you. That I could find two people who could help my son better than you.
I am tired of cleaning up after your mistakes. You got married to get out of your house, Mama,
so I could breathe.
Tammy, you can blame everything in your whole life on me. I can't stop you. But just once, I am gonna stop you before you do something crazy.
Mama, please, I beg you. Please don't do this.
You've given us no choice.
Well, wouldn't we automatically have a say? We're Jesse's closest blood relatives. We're his grandparents.
You're talking common sense, Mr. Jenkins. But the law sometimes works in mysterious ways. See, if Tammy had abandoned the baby in the hospital, he'd be a ward of the state. As relatives, you'd be the first people they'd consider to give the baby to.
So, what's the problem?
Well, this is a private adoption, and your daughter has the right to ask anybody she wants to adopt her child.
Then why is it going to court at all?
A judge still has to approve the adoption to make it legal. And the social workers have to submit a report saying the child will be cared for in the new home. But the legal procedure is strictly between your daughter and the Youngs.
So there's nothing we can do about it?
Well, you can't legally contest a private adoption. But you can, as grandparents, try to get visitation rights. Once the judge knows about you and how much you want Jesse...
Oh, wait a minute. You're saying that if the judge knows that we want Jesse, he might not let the adoption go through?
I'm saying it's possible. The judge is supposed to rule in the best interest of the child.
Well, clearly it's in Jesse's best interest to be with his own family.
Well, that's our job, to prove that to the judge. If he agrees to hear our side, he'll want to know what objections we have to placing Jesse with the Youngs.
Don't get me started.
Well, we need facts. That means a lot of legwork, asking around, and we don't have much time. The Young's adoption hearing's the first week in January.
Department of Mental Health.
Am I supposed to fill this part out here?
Yes, that's right.
Department of Mental Health.
There's Jake.
Yes.
Yes. I'm sorry, but Mr. Fields won't be able to see you today after all.
I've been waiting here all morning. I just need 5 minutes of his time.
He's going to lunch, ma'am.
I'll wait till he gets back.
He's got appointments out of the office the rest of the day.
Is that him? Is that Mr. Fields?
Yes, but...
Excuse me! Mr. Fields?
Yes?
Excuse me!
What is it?
Mr. Fields, excuse me. I'm Lucille Jenkins, and I just need a moment of your time.
about the state guidelines for the raising of handicapped children. I just need to know, in state facilities, what is the ratio of children to child care workers?
Well, that depends. Who'd you say you were?
I'm a grandmother, Mr. Fields. And I just need a moment of your time.
Look at you. I have missed you.
I miss you too.
Why don't I drive you home?
Okay.
Come on, we'll put you back in the truck. Boy, I thought I was gonna forget how to play checkers.
How come I never get to come over anymore?
What does your mother say?
I don't know.
Now, if you want to talk to us, sugar, you just call. You don't need to ask permission. You just pick up the phone.
Okay.
I bet you miss Jessie.
We went over there on Sunday.
To the Youngs? She doesn't have to go to somebody else's house to visit your brother. Wouldn't it be better if Jessie lived with Nanny and Grandpa, and then you could come over all the time and we could be together?
All the time.
Daddy! Daddy, are you here? Daddy!
Bob!
Daddy, go sit in the car, now! You got ice cream at home. Go.
Please, Danny, just do like I tell you, son.
Nobody takes my boy without my say-so.
I left you a message, and you know that he's safe here.
I had plans with my boy today. That's right, my boy. I know you don't want to admit that I'm his daddy. You've never given me any respect, Lucille, not since day one.
You don't storm into my house and demand respect. You earn it. If you honored my relationship with that boy, if you let me see him, then I wouldn't have to snatch him off a playground.
You think I'm not on to you? I know what you're trying to do, Lucille. It's the same old crap you've always pulled.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, no? Why did Tammy's ex-husband show up out of the blue when I was trying to adopt Danny? Who could have called him and stirred up all that trouble? Huh, Lucille?
Danny was happy living here. He didn't want to leave. He cried himself to sleep every night.
You look down your nose at me and at my whole family. I put up with you because I love Tammy. But, Lucille, there's limits.
What you and I think of each other has nothing to do with me seeing Danny. Bob! If you love Tammy, then help her. She's not thinking straight about Jesse. You know that. She needs help.
Try to hear me, Lucille. We made that decision together because we love Jesse. My family understands that.
Are you sure? It's not natural.
Buckle up.
I have been all over town. And from what I can tell, those people could adopt 100 kids and nobody would even bat an eyelash. Jean, I'm at my wit's end. We have offered the kids help. We've offered them money. There must be some way we can keep Jesse and the family. I figure there's power in numbers. Three grandparents fighting for Jesse's got to be better than two.
Lucille, I understand how you feel. I really do.
I knew you would. Bob said that they had your approval, but I knew that couldn't be true.
Lucille, they haven't asked for my approval. I don't think it's my place to tell Bob and Tammy how to live their lives. Listen, it's late. I got a stack of invoices on my desk.
Jean, Jesse is your grandson, too. It doesn't bother you that they're giving him away?
Let it go, Lucille. For your own sake, just let it go.
I can't. I'm sorry, maybe you can. But I can't.
Catch them! Oh, that's a big one, huh?
Whoa,
George? George, come here, quick.
Please. All right, kids, everybody inside. It's lunchtime. Go, kids. Let's go. Come on, everybody inside.
Come on, everybody inside for lunch.
Come on, Tiffany, Thomas. Leave that chair. We'll be there after lunch. Hurry up now.
Go, Dad.
Miss Jenkins, I'm here to see my grandbaby.
Miss Jenkins, I told you on the phone. We have to respect Tammy's and Bob's wishes.
You gave us your word. You said his family would always be welcome.
Ma'am, that was before you all started fighting with us.
I miss him. I just want to see him.
This is our home. Jesse's our son now. You're going to have to get used to that.
Talk to you. How's Jordan? Is he okay?
He's fine. He's much better.
Tammy, why can't I see Jesse? The Youngs refuse to let me see him.
All over town, running those people down. You expect to be welcome there?
Not what I'm doing. I'm just...
Go home.
I am just asking questions. Don't you want to know that that's a good place for your own son?
I do know.
Those people don't even work.
Raising those kids is work, Mama.
Do you know how much money they make off the government? Did you know that they get Social Security for the disabled? That's 12 retarded kids, Tammy. That's 12 times 387. That's over $4,000 tax-free every single month.
Stop it! I can't take anymore, all right? I just can't take it. Listen to yourself, Mama. Listen to how your mind works.
Tam,
go away! Just go away!
They won't let me see Jesse, and now I can't see Danny or Jordan either. It's criminal.
Well, we got enough to file a petition now, Mrs. Jenkins. We'll take our best shot at getting your visitation. Just keep your fingers crossed.
I guess I've been fooling myself. I was hoping that I could have the family back together in time for Christmas.
Nothing's going to happen till after the holidays. I'm sorry.
Mama, are you okay?
Oh, yes, honey, I'm fine. I just need to get some air.
You know, you shouldn't wear yourself out like this. We're not kids anymore. We don't need such a big Christmas.
Oh, baby, that's not what's worn me out. Have you talked to your sister?
Yeah, I tried to call her this morning, but I just got the machine.
She must have received the papers by now. I swear I didn't want this to go to court. How could she do this to us? Robin, you're the one with the fancy college degree. Can you make any sense of this?
Oh, I don't know, Mama. Come on, let's go inside. It's time to open our presents.
Yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your hearts be light from now on. Our troubles will be out of sight. Oh, yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away.
In the back of my mind, I was half thinking your folks were just bluffing about going to court to stop the adoption. Merry Christmas.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, Tammy, no, don't.
No, really, it's not fair. I should have told you. You know, when you took Jesse, you got my mama, too. I knew I shouldn't have dragged you all into this.
Hey, hey. We have been through a lot of adoptions, and I am pretty sure the law is on our side. Can I take that little guy? Ready for bed.
Come on, JJ. Give me a hand.
We're so happy Jesse's here. He's doing so great. It's like Bob and I were praying and God sent you to us.
Oh.
If you want out of this, we'd understand if you changed your mind, Peggy.
Never. Tammy, listen to me. We didn't bring Jesse into our home lightly. We made a commitment to Jesse and to you. You're his birth parents, but he's our son.
But you don't understand, my mother. Mama never loses.
Well, I guess we're supposed to wait down here.
Let's just sit here.
Yeah, let me put the coats in there.
I thought you said they weren't going to be allowed in.
Well, they're not supposed to be. This hearing is just between the adopting parents and the judge.
Well, then what are they doing here? I mean, if we can't go in, why should they be able to go in?
Guess they're hoping the judge will bend the rules. I wouldn't worry about it. It ain't going to happen.
Where are Peggy and George already?
Hey, relax. They'll be here.
She gave them the blanket.
You wait right here.
Your Honor, my clients are the child's grandparents, his blood relatives. All they're asking for today is a chance to be heard.
Now, with all due respect, Your Honor, the birth parents have already relinquished their parental rights. Now, however well-intentioned, the Jenkins are not a party to this proceeding. And there is no precedent that I have found to allow for their participation.
I don't understand. Does that mean you get to keep Jesse?
No, not yet. But Judge Herndon says he's going to consider our rights before he grants the adoption. And that's what we were hoping for.
So you won today?
Yes, that's right. We won.
She doesn't know what she's doing. She can't even look us in the eye.
Baby, this judge is going to give us Jesse. I feel it in my heart. And someday, Tammy's going to thank us.
I just told him they ought to get a new computer.
That was our lawyer on the phone. The Youngs are appealing the judge's decision to consider our rights.
Well, that's no big surprise.
The trouble is, it could take 6 months for the appeals court to rule. In the meantime, Jesse's in limbo, living with the Youngs and not bonding with his family.
Mama, listen. Dawn and I...
All those kids in one little house.
Mama.
Their folks have been turned down to be foster parents who have more room than the Youngs.
Darling, I think our son is trying to tell you something.
What is it?
We're having a baby.
Oh!
Great. Right.
We've been thinking with the baby coming all, we ought to start looking for a bigger place.
I'll call my friend Jackie at River Realty. You remember Jackie. I'll call her tomorrow.
Whoa. We got plenty of time.
Do you realize our new baby will be so close in age to Jesse and Jordan they can grow up together?
Congratulations, Nanny.
You've reached the Fraser residence. We're not able to come to the phone just now, so please leave a message at the tone and we'll get back to you.
Tammy, it's Mama. If you're there, I wish you'd pick up the phone. I just want you to know that if you think you've dug yourself a hole so deep you can't get out, well, you can.
Not too late. There's enough love in this family to forgive anything. We don't want to lose you. Bye.
Mom.
Okay, honey. What are you doing up?
How come Nanny always makes you so sad?
Honey, that's between me and Nanny. That has nothing to do with you.
But Nanny loves you, Mom.
I know. Come here. Getting so heavy. Give me a kiss.
This is great. There's a lot of stuff here. You didn't go out and buy these.
No, they just grow so quick, and Mama bought us so much I never had a chance to use it all.
Thanks for inviting me over.
Oh, I miss you. I miss you, boy. I didn't want to make things hard for you with everything up in the air and all, you know.
I can handle Mama.
You think so?
I'm not like you, Tammy. I'm not always trying to prove something.
You think I'm trying to prove something with Jesse? Is that what you think?
No, I didn't mean that. I was just...
Look, I've made some mistakes in the past. Some big ones, I know that. But that's the past. In Mama's eyes, I'm always going to be 16. She's never going to see that I've grown up. And I have grown up, Ricky. I really have. Giving Jesse to the Youngs, it was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But I know in my heart it was the right thing to do for my son. It was the responsible thing to do. And Mama's never gonna see it that way.
You're the two most stubborn people I know. You and Mama are a lot more alike than you think.
Get out of my house. You know, this didn't just start with me. Half the time, Mama doesn't even talk to her family.
So, I guess there's hope.
I wish you hadn't gone to court, Rick. That really hurt.
They kept asking. Sometimes it's easier to give in.
Well, that's how it starts. You're gonna find out when you and Donna have your baby. You just be careful that you don't give in so much. Pretty soon, you're not the parent anymore. Mama thinks she owns our kids.
It's not gonna happen with us.
Why are you in trouble?
May I help you, ma'am?
My daughter asked me to pick up her pictures. Tammy Frazier? I can't find the receipt.
Oh, well, you just missed her. She was just here picking those up.
Oh, shoot. And I was hoping to have some reprints made.
Well, she's making a couple enlargements. Why don't you take a look at these poses? Tell me what you need.
Thank you.
Okay.
Here's where it stands. The Youngs have won the right to have you excluded from the adoption process. But that doesn't mean the judge won't consider your position now that he knows about you.
Well, the judge still has to rule what's best for Jesse. And this is the same judge that led us into the courtroom in the first place.
Right. The social worker's report is going to be crucial. The judge has to have a reason to stop the Youngs from adopting Jesse.
I found out he's got grandbabies of his own.
Well, that's good. We can use all the help we can get right now. I think it's time to start turning on the pressure.
Please. It's your social workers making the report to Judge Herndon. He won't give Jesse away if you tell him how he's living over at the Youngs. What the place is like.
I assure you, the Youngs are undergoing a thorough investigation. But in a case like this, we report on only three basic needs. Food, clothing, and a roof over the child's head. Now, if the Youngs can provide that...
But we can provide so much more.
We're not here to report on more. We're a government agency, Miss Jenkins, and the law is very specific. As long as the child is safe, we can't make value judgments on where or how he's raised.
I don't understand any of this. How can there be such strict rules for children in foster care and state institutions and not for adoption?
Well, I'm afraid that's just the way it is. And there's nothing more you can do about it. Except change the law.
Oh, I thank you, believe me. When enough people realize what's going on, they're not going to stand for it. I'm just afraid it'll be too late for Jesse.
I agree it's a private matter. I'm just telling you what the lawyer said. The more people know about Jesse's situation, the more pressure there is on the judge to do the right thing.
What kind of magazine is it?
It's called Ladies' World. There's a copy downstairs. The reporter sounded very nice on the phone. She said all we have to do is tell our story. I told her you'd be there.
Why did you say that?
For Jesse, honey.
You never even bothered to ask me. I got a call from that stupid real estate agent today.
Jackie? I told her you were looking for a house.
She said you had one picked out already, right across the street.
It's adorable. And I know you can get it for a steal. Donna, I can't wait to show it to you. Ricky? Ricky! Where are you going? Ricky!
You're pounding me, Mama.
Don't talk to your mother like that. Now, you show some respect.
How about some respect for me? You're trying to run my life, just like you're trying to run Tammy's and everybody else's. Just stop it!
What's happening here, Lucy? What in the hell is happening here? It's like our family is falling apart. Now, look, I know in my heart that we're doing the right thing.
I'll smooth it over with him in the morning. He'll be fine, you see.
I don't know. I don't know anymore, baby. Now, maybe we're going too far with this thing. Maybe we should call that reporter right now and just tell her not to come.
We can't quit now, Lamar. What if Tammy wakes up and realizes what she's done? If we have Jesse, then he'll always be here for her. This publicity may be the only chance we have to keep Jesse in the family.
How did she get this picture? Who gave my mama that picture?
Tammy, honey, I debated whether to show it to you or not. I didn't want you to pick it up in some checkout stand or something.
I'm glad you showed me, Jean. I can't believe she'd go that far.
More letters today, huh?
Oh, this isn't half of it. There's a whole pile in the den. Just from one little...
don't know how I'm going to answer them all. Here's one. From a woman in New Jersey. Her daughter's on drugs, and she's trying to get the baby. I had no idea there were so many people out there who know what we're going through.
Well, I'm going to run upstairs and lie down a bit, okay?
Well, I haven't even started supper. You okay, sugar?
Oh, yeah. Just a little tired.
You can't believe what this place has been like today. The phone's been ringing off the hook. There must have been 50 messages on that machine when I got home.
I didn't even know this machine could take 50 messages.
I saved one for you. You're not going to believe this.
Hi, I'm calling from the Marjorie Duncan Show. We'd like to fly your family to New York to appear on our show. If you could read...
Did you hear that? They want us on the Marjorie Duncan Show. Now, they're going to pay for everything. Airline tickets, hotel, and we'll get to see Robin.
Wait a minute, sweetheart. You know the kind of people they get on that show. I mean, they yell and scream at each other. It's embarrassing.
We're not like those people, sugar. Lamar, millions of viewers watch that show every day.
I really don't know about this.
Judge Herndon could be watching. Now, even if the law won't let us take our case to him in person, they can't stop us from going on national television.
There is just no way I'm going to go on national television with Lucille. No way.
I agree with Bob. She wants to make a fool out of herself. I say we just let her do it.
Look, it's like the lady from the show said. This is our only chance to tell our side of the story. Otherwise, my mama gets to have the last word on everything about our lives. Now, is that what we want? Is that what you want?
All I know is you don't give away your own flesh and blood.
I can't even listen to this anymore.
Okay, Frasers and Youngs, you're on right after this commercial. Come with me.
Go get them, guys.
Marjorie is going to be taking questions during this segment. Now, raise your hand, she'll come to you, and you'll speak directly into the mic, and don't be nervous, all right? And once again, you're doing a great job, and keep that energy up. Thank you very much.
5, 4, 3, 2.
We're back. If you're just tuning in, this is the first time that mother and daughter have actually been in the same room in over 6 months. In just a few days, a judge will decide the fate of little Jesse. The fight for his custody has torn apart what was once the perfect family. Tammy? Let's start with you. Why not let mother and dad take little Jesse if they're willing, if they want to?
Well, first of all, we were never the perfect family. Not by a long shot. And I don't want my child raised the same way that I was raised.
We didn't raise her to give away a baby. Marjorie, we love our daughter. We've given her everything.
Well, I don't want to give Jesse everything.
I don't understand. If she doesn't want Jesse because he's retarded...
That's not it. I love Jesse. I don't think I can give him the same kind of life that the Youngs can give him.
How can she keep the perfect baby and give away the other? How can she dress them up and pose them together and then leave one behind when she's finished taking the pictures?
Well, let's get the picture of the twins up on the monitor real quick. All right, over here.
Tammy, I'm sorry. You just seem like a spoiled, selfish girl who doesn't want to be bothered with...
All right, Tammy, you don't deserve a loving woman like your mother. And I thought my daughter was bad.
Wait a minute. That's not the point. We love our daughter. This is about Jesse.
If you all came to our house, you'd see how we raise our kids. You'd see how beautifully Jesse's doing. If people knew more about Down syndrome... This wouldn't be an issue.
Marjorie, I have nothing against the Youngs. But let me ask you this. Do you think that Jesse would get the same amount of love and attention in a house with 15 kids as he would in our home?
All right, over here.
Mrs. Jenkins, I wish you all the best for what you're trying to do. I hope that you and your family can come together on this and put aside your differences for the sake of the child.
That's exactly what we've been praying for.
As I listen to this, it seems pretty clear that this fight isn't about Jesse at all. There's a lot of stuff going on here, a lot of family stuff that was happening long before Jesse was even born. Am I right?
thought, Dad, we could get a fresh start when the twins came.
Tammy, now, little Jordan, that's Jesse's twin. Now, he had some problems at birth.
Yes, he did, but he is totally healthy now. He's 100% normal.
Tammy, I'm not so sure if we left it up to this audience if you'd be happy with their decision.
Lucille, how can I write this judge and tell him to give you Jesse?
Judge Venable Herndon.
Herndon, Gifford County Superior Court, Municipal Building 1, Suite 703, Gifford County.
And I just want to thank all of my guests for joining us here today. We're out of time, and we're going to see you tomorrow.
Hey, it's got nothing to do with the law. It's just a television show.
I'll tell you one thing. If you and George don't get to keep Jesse, he's coming back with me and Bob, because I am never going to let her have my baby.
Good luck, Mrs. Jenkins. Okay.
How could you? How could you drag the names of my kids through the newspaper, Mama? How could you put their picture on television for everybody to gawk at?
You came on the show same as me, Tammy.
Because you started it. We had to at least defend ourselves.
But nobody thought you were right. Doesn't that tell you something? I don't have to answer to the whole world about my baby's life.
If I have to choose between what the world thinks and what I know is right for my son...
Jesse is my flesh and blood, too. I am doing this for him.
Are you sure, Mama? You sure you're not doing this for yourself? Lucille Jenkins always gets what she wants. It doesn't matter what it does to anybody else.
I didn't think... I didn't know those people would be so cruel to you.
It's not between you and me anymore, Mama. It's up to the judge now. Mama, I am a good mother. I am. I have three children, Danny, Jordan, and Jesse. And just once, I would like to hear you say that I am their mother.
You are their mother.
What's wrong with Daddy? Hurry. Lamar! Lamar, excuse me, please.
What happened? Oh, I can't get up.
Shh. Please, what happened? Could somebody please help me get him to a hospital? Please.
Yeah, call 911, ma'am.
Please! I need to get him to a hospital.
Jack, get him some water, huh?
All right, baby, hold on. Why didn't I see you were sick? How could your daddy not tell me his ulcer was flaring up again? Why would he keep it a secret from me?
Mama, sometimes we're afraid to tell you things. We know how upset you get.
It's ridiculous. I'm strong enough to handle anything.
Yeah, I know. But this whole thing with Tammy, it's just... I mean, it's real hard on everybody.
I guess Daddy's also didn't just flare up all of a sudden by itself.
And Ricky, too. He's caught in the middle.
What about you? All through this whole thing, I've never heard you say how you feel. You're a grown woman. You're entitled to your own opinion. I want to know. I really do.
Mama, I can't say for sure what I would do if I were in Tammy's situation. But I think... I think that she did the right thing for her and for her family.
I wish I could believe that, too. I try to believe that. Can you understand that, honey?
Sure, Mama.
I may not always think the same way you do about everything. But I still love you.
Yeah, I know, Mama. And I love you, too.
Tell you, I'm fine. I'd feel a lot better if you would just stop treating me like an invalid.
This is all my fault. I've been so busy trying to get Jesse back. I've been taking care of you.
You know I knew you'd react this way. I mean, I knew it. Why does everything have to be your personal responsibility, Lucille? I mean, isn't it possible that I got this ulcer all by myself without any help from you?
Honey, I'm always saying.
I know, sweetheart. It's just that if I say something's wrong, you get all worked up trying to fix it.
I guess that's why everybody's always afraid to tell me things. Robin moved 1,000 miles away. Ricky's mad at me now. Tammy hates me. I do wrong. What did I do?
Let me tell you what you did. You raised 3 fine kids, and I may have helped a little bit along the way. But they're grown now, baby, you know, and we just gotta let them go.
They're so different from me.
Maybe that's good. Maybe that's the way we raised them, to be their own people. Lucille, look at me. Look at me. There has never been a parent in the whole history of the planet that did a perfect job. Are you listening to me? Hey, are you listening to me? I love you. I love you so much. And part of the reason that I've always loved you is that you're the bravest person I've ever met. Lucille, you're a fighter. You're like Joan of Arc.
Get out of here.
Come here. Come here. Come here to me. Come here to me.
Baby, what are we gonna do if we don't get Jesse tomorrow?
Well, it's out of our hands now. We'll just accept whatever comes.
Just like that. Make it sound so easy.
What choice do we have? You know, maybe we should start to focus on what we have instead of what we don't have.
And you. And I thank the Lord for that.
Sorry to keep you waiting. How's Jesse doing?
He's doing great. He's learned every day. He's just starting to walk. He's just a joy.
Well, after giving careful consideration to the reports filed by the Department of Family and Child Services. There seems to be no reason not to approve this adoption. Congratulations. Jesse is yours.
Oh, thank you.
We're not happy about the decision, but we understand that Judge is just acting within the law, the way it's written right now.
Have you talked to your daughter today since the decision?
No, we haven't. But we want her to know that we still love her very much, and we always will.
She'll always be our daughter. And Jesse will always be our grandson.
This is Bonnie Raskin reporting from downtown Memphis. Back to you, Jim.
Excuse me.
Where's the truck? Thought for sure we need a bigger room for all your presents.
Well, we got a truckload of love if you want it.
This is a gift certificate. I thought you might want to pick out what you like.
Thanks. Thank you.
You want to hold Jennifer?
Oh, we're only going to stay a minute, I promise. Can't help ourselves. We are gonna love this baby some years. So, if I ever overstep my bounds, I want you to tell me, okay? You're gonna be a good mama and daddy. And all we wanna be is good grandparents.
Stay tuned, because up next on True Movies 1, A Perfect Match. Alternatively on True Movies 2, Struggle to Survive. And on True Entertainment, The Waltons.
Lucille Jenkins always gets what she wants. It doesn't matter what it does to anybody else.
I didn't know those people would be so cruel to you.
It's not between you and me anymore, Mama. It's up to the judge now. Mama? I am a good mother. I am. I have 3 children, Danny, Jordan, and Jesse. And just once, I would like to hear you say that I am their mother.
You are their mother, Tammy.
Mama.
Something's wrong with Daddy. Hurry.
To a hospital, please. Please, I need to get him to a hospital.
Jack, get him some water, huh?
All right, baby, hold on. Why didn't I see you were sick? How could your daddy not tell me his ulcer was flaring up again? Why would you keep it a secret from me?
Mama, sometimes we're afraid to tell you things. We know how upset you get.
It's ridiculous. I'm strong enough to handle anything.
Yeah, I know, I know. But this whole thing with Tammy, it's just... I mean, it's real hard on everybody.
I guess Daddy's also didn't just flare up all of a sudden by itself.
And Ricky, too. He's caught in the middle.
What about you? All through this whole thing, I've never heard you say how you feel. You're a grown woman. You're entitled to your own opinion. I want to know. I really do.
Mom, I can't say for sure what I would do if I were in Tammy's situation. But I think that she did the right thing for her.
Okay.
I don't understand. Does that mean you get to keep Jesse?
No, not yet. But Judge Herndon says he's going to consider our rights before he grants the adoption. And that's what we were hoping for.
So you won today?
Yes, that's right. We won.
She doesn't know what she's doing. She can't even look us in the eye.
Baby, this judge is going to give us Jesse. I feel it in my heart. And someday, Tammy's going to thank us.
I just told him they ought to get a new computer.
That was our lawyer on the phone. The Youngs are appealing the judge's decision to consider our rights.
Well, that's no big surprise.
The trouble is, it could take 6 months for the appeals court to rule. In the meantime, Jesse's in limbo, living with the Youngs and not bonding with his family.
Mama, listen. Don and I...
All those kids in one little house.
Mama.
Their folks have been turned down to be foster parents who have more room than the Youngs.
Darling, I think our son is trying to tell you something.
What is it?
We're having a baby. We've been thinking with the baby coming all, we ought to start looking for a bigger place.
I'll call my friend Jackie at River Realty. You remember Jackie. I'll call her tomorrow.
Whoa. We got plenty of time.
Do you realize our new baby will be so close in age to Jesse and Jordan they can grow up together?
Congratulations, Nanny. Mm-hmm.
You've reached... So now we gotta go get two of everything. We gotta get two bottles, two pacifiers, two cribs, two strollers, two car seats, about 2,000 diapers, two blankets.
Two bikes?
Yeah, two bikes.
Dad?
Yeah.
Why do people have twins?
I don't know. It just happens sometimes.
How come?
Well, it's got something to do with chromosomes.
Dad?
Yeah?
What's chromosomes?
Well, I would imagine that's something better for your science teacher, Mr. Cattleman, but that's what makes babies babies.
Oh.
Don't mow these people down. Say beep, beep.
Beep, beep. Do twins always look exactly alike?
Well, sometimes they do and sometimes they don't.
Well, what if they're exactly alike, but they both turn out to be kind of funny looking?
Kids are always beautiful to the people that love them, even you.
Ha ha.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but Mr. Fields won't be able to see you today after all.
I've been waiting here all morning. I just need 5 minutes this time.
He's gone to lunch, ma'am.
I'll wait till he gets back.
He's got appointments out of the office the rest of the day.
Is that him? Is that Mr. Fields?
Yes, but...
Excuse me! Mr. Fields?
Yes?
Excuse me!
What is it?
Mr. Fields, excuse me. I'm Lucille Jenkins, and I just need a moment of your time. About the state guidelines for the raising of handicapped children, I just need to know, in state facilities, what is the ratio of children to child care workers?
Well, that depends. Who'd you say you were?
I'm a grandmother, Mr. Fields, and I just need a moment of your time.
Look at you. Ooh, I have missed you.
I miss you, too.
Why don't I drive you home?
Okay.
Come on, we'll put you back in the truck. Boy, I thought I was going to forget how to play checkers.
How come I never get to come over anymore?
What does your mother say?
I don't know.
Well, if you want to talk to us, sugar, you just call. You don't need to ask permission. You just pick up the phone.
Okay.
Bet you miss Jesse.
We went over there on Sunday.
To the Youngs? Shouldn't have to go to somebody else's house to visit your brother. Wouldn't it be better if Jesse lived with Nanny and Grandpa, and then you could come over all the time and we could be together?
All the time.
Danny! Danny, are you here? Danny!
Bob!
Danny, go sit in the car, now! You got ice cream at home. Go.
Please, Danny, just do like I tell you, son.
Nobody takes my boy without my say-so.
I left you a message, and you know that he's safe here.
I had plans with my boy today. That's right, my boy. I know you don't want to admit that I'm his daddy. You've never given me any respect, Lucille, not since day one.
You don't storm into my house and demand respect. You earn it. If you honored my relationship with that boy, if you let me see him, then I wouldn't have to snatch him off a playground.
You think I'm not on to you? I know what you're trying to do, Lucille. It's the same old crap you've always pulled.
With us.
Why are you in trouble?
I help you, ma'am?
My daughter asked me to pick up her pictures. Tammy Frazier? I can't find the receipt.
Oh, well, you just missed her. She was just here picking those up.
Oh, shoot. And I was hoping to have some reprints made.
Well, she's making a couple enlargements. Why don't you take a look at these poses? Tell me what you need.
Thank you.
Okay.
Here's where it stands. The Youngs have won the right to have you excluded from the adoption process. But that doesn't mean the judge won't consider your position now that he knows about you.
Well, the judge still has to rule what's best for Jesse. And this is the same judge that led us into the courtroom in the first place.
Right. The social worker's report is going to be crucial. The judge has to have a reason to stop the Youngs from adopting Jesse.
I found out he's got grandbabies of his own.
Well, that's good. We can use all the help we can get right now. I think it's time to start turning on the pressure.
Please. It's your social workers making the report to Judge Herndon. He won't give Jesse away if you tell him how he's living over at the Youngs. What the place is like.
I assure you, the Youngs are undergoing a thorough investigation. But in a case like this, we report on only three basic needs. Food, clothing, and a roof over the child's head. Now, if the Youngs can provide that...
But we can provide so much more.
We're not here to report on more. We're a government agency, Miss Jenkins, and the law is very specific. As long as the child is safe, we can't make value judgments on where or how he's raised.
I don't understand. I don't understand any of this. How can there be such strict rules for children in foster care and state institutions and not for adoption?
Well, I'm afraid that's just the way it is. And there's...
I just told them they ought to get a new computer.
That was our lawyer on the phone. The Youngs are appealing the judge's decision to consider our rights.
Well, that's no big surprise.
The trouble is, it could take 6 months for the appeals court to rule. In the meantime, Jesse's in limbo, living with the Youngs and not bonding with his family.
Mama, listen. Dawn and I...
All those kids in one little house.
Mama.
Their folks have been turned down to be foster parents who have more room than the Youngs.
Darling, I think our son is trying to tell you something.
What is it?
We're having a baby.
Oh!
Oh, and I'm rubbing my belly. Sweet girl.
Great.
We've been thinking with the baby coming all, we ought to start looking for a bigger place.
I'll call my friend Jackie at River Realty. You remember Jackie. I'll call her tomorrow.
Whoa. We got plenty of time.
Do you realize our new baby will be so close in age to Jesse and Jordan they can grow up together?
Congratulations, Nanny. Mm-hmm.
You've reached the Frazier residence. We're not able to come to the phone just now, so please leave a message at the tone and we'll get back to you.
Tammy? It's Mama. If you're there, I wish you'd pick up the phone. I just want you to know that if you think you've dug yourself a hole so deep you can't get out, well, you can.
Not too late. There's enough love in this family to forgive anything. We don't want to lose you. Bye.
Mom. Okay, honey. What are you doing up?
How come Nanny always makes you so sad?
Honey, that's between me and Nanny. That has not... Mama's here for you. It's gonna be okay. We'll be fine. Are you here?
There are a couple of special schools and one or two outpatient programs in the area. Now, you'll be eligible for assistance. I've got a list of agencies for you to contact when you feel ready. I'm just going to leave these here. I just want you to know there's help available if you need it. Information and advice, other parents who are raising Down syndrome kids.
Trust us, but that doesn't mean the judge won't consider your position now that he knows about you.
Well, the judge still has to rule what's best for Jesse. And this is the same judge that led us into the courtroom in the first place.
Right. The social worker's report is going to be crucial. The judge has to have a reason to stop the Youngs from adopting Jesse.
I found out he's got grandbabies of his own.
Well, that's good. We can use all the help we can get right now. I think it's time to start turning on the pressure.
Please. It's your social workers making the report to Judge Herndon. He won't give Jesse away if you tell him how he's living over at the Youngs. What the place is like.
I assure you, the Youngs are undergoing a thorough investigation. But in a case like this, we report on only three basic needs. Food, clothing, and a roof over the child's head. Now, if the Youngs can provide that...
But we can provide so much more.
We're not here to report on more. We're a government agency, Miss Jenkins, and the law is very specific. As long as the child is safe, we can't make value judgments on where or how he's raised.
I don't understand any of this. How can there be such strict rules for children in foster care and state institutions and not for adoption?
Well, I'm afraid that's just the way it is. And there's nothing more you can do about it. Except change the law.
Oh, I plan to, believe me. When enough people realize what's going on, they're not going to stand for it. I'm just afraid it'll be too late for Jesse.
I agree it's a private matter. I'm just telling you what the lawyer said. The more people know about Jesse's situation, the more pressure there is on the judge to do the right thing.
What kind of magazine is it?
It's called Ladies' World. There's a copy downstairs. The reporter sounded very nice on the phone. She said all we have to do is tell our story. I told her you'd be there.
Why did you say that?
It's for Jesse, honey.
You never even bothered to ask me. I got a call from that stupid real estate agent today.
Jackie? I told her you were looking for a house.
She said you had one picked out already, right across the street.
It's adorable. And I know you can get it for a steal. Donna, I can't wait to show it to you. Ricky? Ricky! Where are you going? Ricky!
You're pounding me, Mama.
Don't talk to your mother like that. Now, you show some respect.
How about some respect for me? You're trying to run my life, just like you're trying to run Tammy's and everybody else's. Just stop it!
What's happening here, Lucy? What in the hell is happening here? It's like our family is falling apart. Now look, I know in my heart that we're doing
the
right thing.
I'll smooth it over with him in the morning. He'll be fine, you see.
I don't know. I don't know anymore, baby. Now, maybe we're going too far with this. Tell you, I'm fine. I'd feel a lot better if you would just stop treating me like an invalid.
This is all my fault. I've been so busy trying to get Jesse back. I haven't been taking care of you.
You know, I knew you'd react this way. I mean, I knew it. Why does everything have to be your personal responsibility, Lucille? I mean, isn't it possible that I got this ulcer all by myself without any help from you?
Honey, I'm only saying.
I know, sweetheart. It's just that if I say something's wrong, you get all worked up trying to fix it.
I guess that's why everybody's always afraid to tell me things. Robin moved 1,000 miles away. Ricky's mad at me now. Tammy hates me. I do wrong. What did I do?
Let me tell you what you did. You raised 3 fine kids, and I may have helped a little bit along the way. But they're grown now, baby, you know, and we just gotta let them go.
They're so different from me.
Maybe that's good. Maybe that's the way we raised them, to be their own people. Lucille, look at me. Look at me. There has never been a parent in the whole history of the planet that did a perfect job. Are you listening to me? Hey, are you listening to me? I love you. I love you so much. And part of the reason that I've always loved you is that you're the bravest person I've ever met. Lucille, you're a fighter. You're like Joan of Arc.
Get out of here.
Come here. Come here to me. Come here to me.
Baby, what are we going to do if we don't get Jesse tomorrow?
Well, it's out of our hands now. We'll just accept whatever comes.
Just like that. Make it sound so easy.
What choice do we have? You know, maybe we should start to focus on what we have instead of what we don't have.
And you. And I thank the Lord for that. Baby, what are we going to do if we don't get Jesse tomorrow?
Well, it's out of our hands now. We'll just accept whatever comes.
Just like that. Make it sound so easy.
What choice do we have? You know, maybe we should start to focus on what we have instead of what we don't have.
And you. And I thank the Lord for that.
Sorry to keep you waiting. How's Jesse doing?
He's doing great. He's learning every day. He's just starting to walk. He's just a joy.
Well, after giving careful consideration to the reports filed by the Department of Family and Child Services, there seems to be no reason not to approve this adoption. Congratulations. Jesse is yours.
Oh, thank you.
We're not happy about the decision, but we understand that Judge is just acting within the law, the way it's written right now.
Have you talked to your daughter today since the decision?
No, we haven't.
Okay.
I don't understand. Does that mean you get to keep Jesse?
No, not yet. But Judge Herndon says he's going to consider our rights before he grants the adoption. And that's what we were hoping for.
So you won today?
Yes. That's right. We won.
She doesn't know what she's doing. She can't even look us in the eye.
Baby. This judge is going to give us Jesse. I feel it in my heart. And someday, Tammy's going to thank us.
I just told him they ought to get a new computer.
That was our lawyer on the phone. The Youngs are appealing the judge's decision to consider our rights.
Well, that's no big surprise.
The trouble is, it could take 6 months for the appeals court to rule. In the meantime, Jesse's in limbo, living with the Youngs and not bonding with his family.
Mama, listen. Donna and I...
All those kids in one little house.
Mama.
Their folks have been turned down to be foster parents who have more room than the Youngs.
Darling, I think our son is trying to tell you something.
What is it?
We're having a baby. We've been thinking with the baby coming on, we ought to start looking for a bigger place.
I'll call my friend Jackie at River Realty. You remember Jackie. I'll call her tomorrow.
Whoa. We got plenty of time.
Do you realize our new baby will be so close in age to Jesse and Jordan they can grow up together?
Congratulations, Nanny. Mm-hmm.
You've reached the Fraser residence.
In Mama's eyes, I'm always going to be 16. She's never going to see that I've grown up. And I have grown up, Ricky. I really have. Giving Jesse to the Youngs, it was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But I know in my heart, it was the right thing to do for my son. It was the responsible thing to do. And Mama's never gonna see it that way.
You're the two most stubborn people I know. You and Mama are a lot more alike than you think.
Get out of my house. You know, this didn't just start with me. Half the time, Mama doesn't even talk to her family.
So, I guess there's hope.
I wish you hadn't gone to court, Rick. That really hurt.
They kept asking. Sometimes it's easier to give in.
Well, that's how it starts. You're gonna find out when you and Donna have your baby. You just be careful that you don't give in so much. Pretty soon, you're not the parent anymore. Mama thinks she owns our kids.
It's not gonna happen with us.
Why are you in trouble?
May I help you, ma'am?
My daughter asked me to pick up her pictures. Tammy Fraser. I can't find the receipt.
Oh, well, you just missed her. She was just here picking those up.
Oh, shoot. And I was hoping to have some reprints made.
Well, she's making a couple enlargements. Why don't you take a look at these poses? Tell me what you need.
Thank you. Publicity may be the only chance we have to keep Jesse in the family.
How did she get this picture? Who gave my mama that picture?
Tammy, honey, I debated whether to show it to you or not. I didn't want you to pick it up in some checkout stand or something.
I'm glad you showed me, Jean. I can't believe she'd go that far.
More letters today, huh?
Oh, this isn't the half of it. There's a whole pile in the den. Just from one little article. I don't know how I'm going to answer them all. Here's one. From a woman in New Jersey. Her daughter's on drugs, and she's trying to get the baby. I had no idea there were so many people out there who know what we're going through.
Well, I'm going to run upstairs and lie down a bit, okay?
I haven't even started supper. You okay, sugar?
Oh, yeah. Just a little tired.
You can't believe what this place has been like today. The phone's been ringing off the hook. There must have been 50 messages on that machine when I got home.
I didn't know this machine could take 50 messages.
I saved one for you. You're not going to believe this.
Hi, I'm calling from the Marjorie Duncan Show. We'd like to fly your family to New York to appear on our show. If you could read...
Did you hear that? They want us on the Marjorie Duncan Show. No, they're going to pay for everything. Airline tickets, hotel, and we'll get to see Robin.
Wait a minute, sweetheart. You know the kind of people they get on that show. I mean, they yell and scream at each other. It's embarrassing.
We're not like those people, sugar. Lamar, millions of viewers watch that show every day.
I really don't know about this.
Judge Herndon could be watching.
Even if the law won't let us take our case to him in person, they can't stop us from going on national television.
There is just no way I'm going to go on national television with Lucille. No way.
I agree with Bob. She wants to make a fool out of herself. I say we just let her do it.
Look, it's like the lady from the show said, this is our only chance to tell our side of the story. Otherwise, my mama gets to have the last word on everything about our lives. Now, is that what we want? Is that what you want?
All I know is you don't give away your own flesh and blood.
I can't even listen to this anymore. Okay, Frasers and Youngs, you're on right after this commercial. Come with me.
Go get them, guys. The cable's over here.
Marjorie is going to be taking questions during this segment. Now,
there's a baby. There's a baby. There's a
sorry to keep you waiting. How's Jesse doing?
He's doing great. He's learning every day. He's just starting to walk. He's just a joy.
Well, after giving careful consideration to the reports filed by the Department of Family and Child Services, there seems to be no reason not to approve this adoption. Congratulations. Jesse is yours.
Oh, thank you.
We're not happy about the decision, but we understand that Judge is just acting within the law, the way it's written right now.
Have you talked to your daughter today since the decision?
No, we haven't. But we want her to know that we still love her very much, and we always will.
She'll always be our daughter. And Jesse will always be our grandson.
This is Bonnie Raskin reporting from downtown Memphis. Back to you, Jim.
Excuse me.
Where's the truck?
You've reached the Fraser residence. We're not able to come to the phone just now, so please leave a message at the tone and we'll get back to you.
Tammy, it's Mama.
If you're there, I wish you'd pick up the phone. I just want you to know that if you think you've dug yourself a hole so deep you can't get out, well, you can. Not too late. There's enough love in this family to forgive anything. We don't want to lose you. Bye.
Mom. Okay, honey. What are you doing up?
How come Nanny always makes you so sad?
Honey, that's between me and Nanny. That has nothing to do with you.
But Nanny loves you, Mom.
I know. Come here. Ugh, getting so heavy. Give me a kiss.
This is great. There's a lot of stuff here. You didn't go out and buy these.
No, they just grow so quick, and Mama bought us so much I never had a chance to use it all.
Thanks for inviting me over.
Oh, I miss you. I miss you, boy. I didn't want to make things hard for you with everything up in the air and all, you know.
I can handle Mama.
You think so?
Not like you, Tammy. I'm not always trying to prove something.
You think I'm trying to prove something with Jesse? Is that what you think?
No, I didn't mean that. I was just...
Look, I've made some mistakes in the past. Some big ones, I know that. But that's the past. In Mama's eyes, I'm always going to be 16. She's never going to see that I've grown up. And I have grown up, Ricky. I really have. Giving Jesse to the Youngs was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But I know in my heart it was...
I need you to understand something.
Tammy, you're right.
I have nothing against those people. I'm just grateful you're not one of those poor people with no family to help out. Oh, no, Mama, these are my groceries.
Oh, don't be silly. It's my pleasure. And anything you need for Jesse, you just have to ask. Anything. You know that, don't you? Well, now that you're in the family, I guess I'll have to reveal my secret ingredient. I'm gonna make a Jenkins out of this girl yet.
I don't know, Donna. Run for the hills if I were you.
Pay no attention to
him. I never do.
Well, Rick, I called your sister up in New York today. That man answered the telephone again. Robin's not living with him, is she?
Mama, how would I know? You know how Robin is. She never tells us anything.
And if she did, you wouldn't tell me, would you?
Probably not.
Hey, you guys! You want to come in and lick the bowl? Chocolate frosted! Fresh lemonade!
Okay, just a minute!
It's so good to have Danny back again. When Tammy gets here, it'll be the first time in I don't know when, but most of the family's been together.
You hear from the hospital?
They put Jordan on a respirator. But Tammy, I think she's a bit overwhelmed.
So sad. I think she made the right decision.
What decision?
Tammy's been trying to tell you, Mama. I think she's a little scared.
Scared? Of what? I'm her mama. What on earth can't she tell me? What decision? Where's Tammy Frazier?
Right there.
Could you?
Mama?
Tell me you are not going to give Jesse to those people.
Mama?
Tell me you are not going to give my grandson to strangers.
Look, this isn't the time or the place, Mama. People are looking at us.
I don't care who's looking at us. I want to know about Jesse.
I'm sorry. I can't do this right now, Mama. I've got to go talk to the doctor.
Don't you walk away from me when I'm talking to you. I am your mother, and I'm telling you, you are not going to give that baby away.
Stop it, Mama.
Thank you.
So you won today.
Yes, that's right. We won.
She doesn't know what she's doing. She can't even look us in the eye.
Baby, this judge is going to give us Jesse. I feel it in my heart. And someday, Tammy's going to thank us.
I just told him they ought to get a new computer.
That was our lawyer on the phone. The Youngs are appealing the judge's decision to consider our rights.
Well, that's no big surprise.
The trouble is, it could take 6 months for the appeals court to rule. In the meantime, Jesse's in limbo, living with the Youngs and not bonding with his family.
Mama, listen. Donna and I...
All those kids in one little house.
Mama.
Their folks have been turned down to be foster parents who have more room than the Youngs.
Darling, I think our son is trying to tell you something.
What is it?
We're having a baby. We've been thinking with the baby coming all, we ought to start looking for a bigger place.
I'll call my friend Jackie at River Realty. You remember Jackie. I'll call her tomorrow.
Whoa. We got plenty of time.
Do you realize our new baby will be so close in age to Jesse and Jordan they can grow up together?
Congratulations, Nanny.
We've reached the Fraser residence. We're not able to come to the phone just now, so please leave a message at the tone and we'll get back to you.
Tammy, it's Mama. If you're there, I wish you'd pick up the phone.
There are a couple of special schools and one or two outpatient programs in the area. Now, you'll be eligible for assistance. I've got a list of agencies for you to contact when you feel ready. I'm just going to leave these here. I just want you to know there's help available if you need it. Information and advice, other parents who are raising Down syndrome kids, if you want to talk. Look, I know this can be overwhelming. Just get some rest, and I'll be back later.
You were good, Slugger.
Of course he was. He's my boy.
Here you go.
I've got him, Bob. Why don't you get Tammy's bags?
Mama, I can take one of those.
Honey, you know how heavy these contraptions are. Let me.
Come on, sweetie. You're
how do you do that?
I'm going to be late. Listen, honey, I'm getting off the night shift, that's why.
I know.
I love you.
I love you too.
I'll see you. Bye, Lucille.
Bye. I don't know what we're going to do.
Hey, honey. Daddy and I had our hands full when we brought Robin and Lucy home from the hospital. But we made out fine, didn't we?
But, Mama, you didn't have to work. You didn't have doctor bills. You didn't have a sick baby. And another one with Down syndrome. An 8-year-old to take care of all at once.
You make it sound like you're in this all by yourself. You're not. You have a mom and a daddy who love you. Mama, I know we've had our differences.
My clients are the child's grandparents, his blood relatives. All they're asking for today is a chance to be heard.
Now, with all due respect, Your Honor, the birth parents have already relinquished their parental rights. Now, however well-intentioned, the Jenkins are not a party to this proceeding. And there is no precedent that I have found to allow for their participation.
You're in.
God in heaven.
Damn it.
Just knew she'd find a way to get herself in there. I just knew it.
I don't understand. Does that mean you get to keep Jesse?
No, no, not yet. But Judge Herndon says he's going to consider our rights before he grants the adoption. And that's what we were hoping for.
So you won today?
Yes, that's right. We won.
She doesn't know what she's doing. She can't even look us in the eye.
Baby, this judge is going to give us Jesse. I feel it in my heart. And someday, Tammy's going to thank us.
I just told him they ought to get a new computer.
That was our lawyer on the phone. The Youngs are appealing the judge's decision to consider our rights.
Well, that's no big surprise.
The trouble is, it could take 6 months for the appeals court to rule. In the meantime, Jesse's in limbo, living with the Youngs and not bonding with his family.
Mama, listen. Donna and I...
All those kids in one little house.
Mama.
Their folks have been turned down to be foster parents who have more room than the Youngs.
Darling, I think our son is trying to tell you something.
What is it?
We're having a baby. We've been thinking with the baby coming all, we ought to start looking for a bigger place.
I'll call my friend Jackie at River Realty. You remember Jackie? I'll call her.
Are you here?
Did you wake up to see Nanny?
Oh, you had me coming to see you.
Didn't you? Here I be.
There are a couple of special schools and one or two outpatient programs in the area. Now, you'll be eligible for assistance. I've got a list of agencies for you to contact when you feel ready. I'm just going to leave these here. I just want you to know there's help available if you need it. Information and advice, other parents who are raising Down syndrome kids, if you want to talk. Look, I know this can be overwhelming. Just get some rest, and I'll be back later.
You were good, Slugger.
Of course he was. He's my boy.
Here you go.
I've got him, Bob. Why don't you get Tammy's bags?
Mama, I can take one of those.
Honey, you know how heavy these contraptions are. Let me.